And the special team with so much cap space, but they're not putting a premium. They didn't imagine that Catanzaro, who they brought back and let walk as he had a great season at Tampa, would come back and retire on him. You know, Jay Feely, where you at? Nick Folk, where you at? Come on back, man. Come on, come on.
Oh, Bart, well, it was good to have you. Hopefully, maybe this is just some growing pains. We get to the middle of the season.
Only 5 minutes for the suit?
Dang. Well, you call it a 20-minute suit?
Yeah, it's a 25-minute suit.
Oh, 25 minutes.
Yeah, right. I got another show. I got another 18
minutes. Oh, really?
Hey.
I got another 18 minutes left.
Speaking of that show, this suit is getting some more airtime today. Much more in Game Green. You want to keep it locked here for Jets Game Plan at 6:30 as Bart will join Ray Lucas and Jhené Coakley to break down the Sam Darnold fallout and preview Monday night's matchup with the Browns. That's 6:30 right here on SNY. But ahead for us here in the thread, we have more updates from Jets practice today. The Jets will miss Sam Darnold for a while, but what about Le'Veon Bell? A big update on the running back is on the other side of a break.
For the past 42 years, and with over 28 million sold, more people have put their hard-earned money on a Ford F-Series truck than any other pickup in America. Yeah, I'd say that's money well spent. It's Ford Truck Month, America. Time to join the stampede.
This truck month, get an F-150 with up to $14,270 total savings or lease for $169 a month. See details at buyfordnow.com.
Hey, let's make this interesting. Throw down some money right now, and you could earn up to $500 in bonus cash.
I'm going to get extra greenbacks, just like that.
Abraham, you know I always keep it 100.
You'd do that for me?
No, but DraftKings would.
DraftKings, the U.S. sports book for the U.S. sports fan. Everyone gets a deposit bonus up to $500. Plus, we'll match your first bet up to $200. So download the top-rated sportsbook app and make it rain.
Doug. And now, for their service to the community, we present Limu Imu and Doug with this key to the city.
It's an honor to tell you that Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance so you only pay for what you need. And now, we need to get back to work.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Dear Adrenaline, you run in our veins. Let's hit the road with the wind in our grills and the gravel under our wheels. Anytime you want to tear up some trails, just drop us a gas line. Your squad, Toyota Trucks.
Right now, get $1,000 customer cash on a new 4Runner or get $1,500 customer cash on a new Tacoma. Find yours at buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Let's start a thread in the news. Good news for Yanks fans. Luis Severino is scheduled to make his season debut Tuesday versus the Angels. That's also when Giancarlo Stanton is expected to rejoin the team. And Dellin Betances could be back in the Bronx in a few days. He's slated to make one more rehab appearance tomorrow. Some bad news, though. Edwin Encarnacion left today's game with an oblique strain. The Jets did get some good news today. Yes, they did. An MRI on Le'Veon Bell's shoulder showed no major damage, according to Jeremy Fowler of ESPN. The test was precautionary, and he should be able to play Monday. But, of course, Sam Darnold definitely won't play Week 2. And Ralph Vecchiano is more in today's direct message.
This is an absolutely devastating blow for the Jets. It's hard to think of a worse situation they could be in than losing Sam Darnold, possibly for up to a month with mono. They were already facing a very, very difficult schedule in the first 6 weeks of the season. Obviously, they struggled on opening day, especially on offense, and they were looking forward to Sam Darnold being the guy who pulled them out of it. Now they're going to have to rely on Trevor Siemian, who's a capable backup, but certainly not in Darnold's class. And let's face it, Adam Gase spent the entire offseason telling us how Sam Darnold was the key to everything. They really thought that this was the year that he was going to step up and become one of the elite quarterbacks in the league. And now, this early in the season, for the Jets to lose him, it is absolutely crushing, and it's going to be very difficult for them to survive the next few weeks without him. Back to you, Justine.
Castradamus.
If you think about it, should we be concerned that the Jets start this season 0-6? Where would you put that on the panic meter?
New York, New Jersey, tri-state area. I'm freaking out right now. We're at the number 5. Turn it up. Do the speedometer thing. Get it up, man.
Gastrodamus.
Oh, gosh. I so wish I was wrong.
All right, so let's get your take on the Jets, Kaz. You're at 5 on Tuesday. Where are you at now, man?
Yo, like 15? If there's something that goes past the 5, like over the speedometer, I'm freaking out right now. I've been calling them the Jenga Jets in my group chat for a while because they're very top heavy. And Bart just came and said, you know, the starters are really good, but you know when you play Jenga and you build it up really good and you're building something that looks really nice, but if that one piece comes out, it all goes to hell.
That's
what happened with CJ Mosley. And now that's happened times two with Sam Darnold right now. And I know there's going to be a lot of jokes with the mono and all that type of stuff, but it's very serious, you know. It could really damage your liver. And, you know, seeing how bad that O-line looked this past week, the last thing you want is that guy to get hit in the liver, and now his career is in jeopardy. So I'm glad that they're sitting him out for a little while, and I'm terrified right now. Like, happily, you know, Le'Veon Bell is going to, you know, play, and he looks like he's going to be okay. But right now, man, especially with the Browns on Monday, Patriots in New England after that, the Cowboys, Eagles, Patriots again,
right?
0-6, man. It's looking.
There's no way to.
My God.
There's no way to sugarcoat this.
It's scary.
We can sit here and talk about how Seaman can fit in.
Spooky hours. Like, as
I trust Bart Scott more than anyone to talk about the Jets here, right? But if you're a Jets fan, how are you not looking at the schedule right now in 0-6? You have a pissed off Cleveland Browns team coming in here on Monday night. You just talked about the schedule. You have the Pats coming up twice with a bye week in between there. And the biggest problem for me is that Darnold was like clearly evolving into whatever the next tier was for a quarterback. He was a rookie. He was learning from his mistakes. He looked great in the preseason, and that's why you can only take it with a grain of salt in the preseason, because stuff like this happens, and now it's like, what? All the questions of the what ifs of Sam Darnold was surrounded with a running back and an offensive line and coherent wide receivers. Those were all answered in the offseason, and this was supposed to be putting it all together. Guess what? Now he's out. Like,
yeah. I mean, to be fair, messy. I mean, Trevor Siemian's been a solid NFL quarterback. He's not great. Right. He's not a world beater, but he's somebody that can hold the fort, especially if Le'Veon Bell is healthy. So maybe they can hold it down. Maybe Darnold's out for 1 week. Maybe it's four. But yes, I'm very terrified as a Jets fan.
Somebody said the Jets season is over before the Mets. I don't think any of us thought we'd be hearing that.
All right, let's hit the stack. I know, crazy. First up, Brandon Nimmo recorded the fastest home run trot in the MLB this season at 16.89 seconds. So here's the question. Can Nimmo round the bases twice before Bartolo Colon could round the bases once from his famous homer in 2016?
Most glorious trot in not Mets history, but just Major League history.
What a sexy man, Bartolo.
Big sexy trot, baby.
Yo. Oh, my goodness. Oh, it's beautiful.
And the fact that Nimmo sprints to first base, too, like, you have to think he could round. He could lap him.
Oh, of course. Do you think he sprints too fast? Do you think he runs too fast?
It's probably a little obnoxious. I'm not going to lie. Yeah. It's a little too fast for my taste.
Exactly. Not nearly as sexy as Bartolo, though. Look at that. Lovely man.
Big daddy. All right, next up, we've been waiting all week to show you this, Kaz.
Oh, yes.
Here's the breakdown.
Oh, let's break it down. We got the big man in his cancer in Madison Square Garden going against my man, R-Truth, the 24-7 champion. And remember, the 24-7 title is defended every... Oh, my God. A pop face to the ground in his cancer with the roll-up. 1, 2, 3, and his cancer, the brand new WWE 24/7. Look at this.
Cute green.
Oh. You hate to see that. Oh my goodness. And it's cancer. We love you. The scoreboard. Our truth. And he wins back the WWE 24/7 championship. Oh my goodness, just like the Knicks are gonna do to the Celtics all year. And his cancer's gonna be looking with his arms up like, what are you?
He looked like that a lot on the Knicks too. Where was that?
Oh my gosh, Kaz, that was great play-by-play. Justine, you gotta give it credit.
Okay. Two Heisman Trophy winning quarterbacks go at it under the Thursday night lights tonight in the NFL. So are we putting our money on Cam or Jameis? Better Beware is next.
The Thread is brought to you by the Citi Rewards Plus Card. It rounds your points up to the nearest 10 on every purchase, so you can score big points even on the little things.
some run from the weather. But with the most capable and luxurious SUV in its class, you can run through it. Jeep Grand Cherokee. Hurry into Jeep Adventure Days for a great deal. Well-qualified returning lessees get a low-mileage lease on select 2019 Jeep Grand Cherokee models for $199 a month.
Look, Grandpa, I got you the Echo Show. You can ask it to play music or check the weather. Valerie, Valerie. Alexa, at 6 p.m., remind Grandpa your favorite dessert's in the fridge.
Okay, I'll set a reminder.
Valerie. Alexa, play the song that goes Valerie.
Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water.
Tomorrow, Pete Alonso aims to get closer to the rookie home run record by barreling a few up at home as the Polar Bear looks to go deep against Clayton Kershaw and the Dodgers. Mets, Dodgers, presented by Citi. Coverage begins tomorrow at 6:30, only on SNY.
Alonso drives one to deep center field. And it's out of here! And McNeil's got his fourth end of the day.
All right, time for Better Beware, an NFC South battle for Thursday Night Football as the Bucs travel to Charlotte to take on the Panthers. Carolina is favored by a touchdown. Cash, who you got, Cam Newton?
Degenerate gamblers know that the safest bet in NFL football is the home team on a Thursday night game. I got the Carolina Panthers going 2 touchdowns over the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and a turnover machine, Jameis Winston. Panthers up.
I'm taking the 7 points, but the plus 7 with the Bucs. It's a divisional game against a Bucs defense that only gave up 2. I know they blew it against San Francisco, but they only gave up 256 yards last week. In addition to that, Greg Olsen has a back problem. I don't know who's Cam Newton thrown to besides the concession boys. All you have out there is McCaffrey. It's 7 points. You're betting the number as much as you're betting the team itself when it comes to gambling. 7's too many points for me. The Panthers probably win this game straight up, but within the number at the very least for me.
I got the Panthers, 21 points. I think McCaffrey's going to run all over. Woo! The Bucs defense.
Like Jameis
Winston is going to be a turnover machine.
Say, I know it's crazy. But
bounce back, Gabe, my friend. Bounce back.
I like the Panthers in this one. Jameis Winston has the most losses on the road of any quarterback.
Okay.
I'm off to next. We'll see you tomorrow at 5.